So, is your newspaper going to make Glendarroch famous?
Maybe that's just what we're going to do.
Well, I'm the pin-up girl of Glendarroch, if you're looking for someone for page 3.
Oh, yes. Don't call us, we'll call you.
I thought reporters were always rushing about looking for scoops and things. You look more as if you're posing for a statue.
As a matter of fact, I'm waiting for a phone call. Mrs. Blair has been kind enough to let me take it here.
Ah, she's a kind hearted, Isabel. Wouldn't see you standing out in the cold, no matter who you are or what you're doing. What are you doing, by the way?
I'm standing like a statue, waiting for a scoop to come rushing up to me.
There are no scoops in Glendarroch today. If there were, I'd be the first to know about it.
Mm-hmm.
Would you settle for a bit of gossip?
Hey, I know who you are now. You're the William Hickey of Glendarroch.
Oh, that'll be right. But there's not much goes on here that goes by me. So, if you just tell me what it is you're after, I could probably save you overworking your legs. Though at the moment, there doesn't seem much danger of that happening.
I'm doing a series of articles on stately homes.
Huh?
You don't happen to live in one, do you?
No. Oh, but she does.
What does she do, Maggie?
Live in a stately home. This young fellow's writing about them.
Is he? Oh, yes. Mr. Maxwell, isn't he? I've heard that you've been snooping around. First class, thank you.
Looking around would be my word for it, Mrs. Cunningham. But then words are my business. Still, it's a bit of luck my running into you like this.
He calls that running.
I've been meaning to have a word with you.
About Glendarroch House. I think you could find out all there is to know about it from the guidebooks, Mr. Maxwell.
Oh, I've read them. There isn't much human interest in them. I'd like to know things like how it feels being a tenant on the estate you used to own, how you've managed to adjust to it. That'll be for me, excuse me.
Yes, he is.
Thanks. Yes? Yes, Maxwell here.
No.
You're sending who? Parker. Well, that's great. Look, I'm onto something at the moment. Hold the line. Mrs. Cunningham.
Good morning, Mr. Maxwell.
Yes. Hello? Yeah. Tell Parker to get his camera up here fast. Well, I need pictures.
$16.48. Mm-hmm. 31.16.
I've just met that reporter at the shop. Now, he claims that he's writing about country houses, but I don't believe a word of it.
Oh. Thanks, Lorna. We'll finish that later.
Oh, thanks, Lorna.
No, if that's all he was interested in, he would have come straight to the door, talked to us, and then gone right back and written his article.
Mm.
That's what, a day's work? He's been here longer than that.
Whatever he's interested in, he might have had the courtesy to come straight to us.
I wonder why he didn't.
He looked to me like a typical representative of the gutter press. You know how they work. Stir up trouble and see what comes of it. And I think that's exactly what he's been doing. He's unsettling people. Somehow he's heard about Langerman's plans for the estate, but how?
Do you think it could be Langerman himself?
I don't believe it.
Well, maybe he's leaked information.
Well, why would he do that?
Well, to test the temperature. Like dipping your toe into the water before you take the plunge.
To find out how strong the opposition to making Glendarroch a pleasure complex might be.
That's right. Public opinion still counts for something. It stopped a lot of plans being carried through and held up an awful lot more.
I don't think Langerman would risk that.
Well, there's no risk. You just start a few rumours, stir things up a bit, and then you study the reaction. Find out who you have to reassure, who you have to placate, maybe even who you have to bribe. Then when you put the plans into action, you've asked all the questions and found all the answers.
Meaning that Mr. Langerman has sunk to using backdoor methods.
Mm. I don't think Herr Langerman would see it that way. He would see it simply as business tactics. But to be fair to him, we don't know he's done anything yet.
Well, there's one way to find out. I'll ask him. Lorna, get me Max Langerman in Frankfurt.
Don't worry, Mrs. Lachlan. Dougal's going to be all right.
But he's never done this before, staying out all night. I'm nearly out of my mind wondering what's happened to him.
Have you no idea where he might have gone?
Well, you were here. He never said. He just went out as if he was going to his work as usual. And that's the last we've seen of him.
He's all right, Mrs. Lachlan. I know he is. It's partly because of me. He resents me being here.
Oh, he resents everything these days. I don't know what's going to become of him.
When he comes back, I maybe ought to think about leaving.
But I don't want you to go. I need you here, Alice.
Well, first we better find out what's happened to him.
Is that him now?
Oh, it's Nurse Grant. Heavens, Nurse Grant came. I couldn't have left you and the baby alone. She's gone straight over to Ardvain to get the men out to look for him, and then she's going to phone Mr. McIntyre from the main road.
But did we have to do all that? If he's all right, Dougal wouldn't thank you for making a fuss.
Let's just see if he is all right first.
Things have been a bit rough for me over the last few years, Jimmy. I don't think I'm past the worst of it now. Now that the oil rep's coming, if I get that franchise, maybe get me some money. Help me get on my feet.
It was different in the old days, Ken. People would drive 10 miles there and 10 miles back for the petrol. Mm-hmm. Nowadays, they'd need a bank loan before they set out. No, the nearest garage will get all the business. And once you get the franchise, you'll be able to put your prices up a bit and it'll still be worth their while.
I could service those boats of yours if you ever get that idea of yours about the pier off the ground.
Yeah, it's off the ground.
No, I'm not talking about the pier. I'm talking about your boats and the water skiing and like.
So am I. They're both off the ground. In fact, I told the factor about my plans yesterday and he was very encouraging.
Was he indeed?
Aye. Well.
Have you heard the latest?
Well, depends on what you're talking about, Maggie. I mean, we've heard a lot of things, haven't we, Jim?
Have you heard what the Germans are going to do to Glendarroch?
An invasion, is it? Well, we haven't got Winston Churchill to win the war for us this time. You take my advice and head straight for the hills.
Aye, right away.
Oh, you think it's funny. But you'll laugh on the other side of your face when they take over. They're going to move us all out, make it into a big holiday camp, only just for millionaires and the like.
Well, Jimmy and I'll just stay on as guests, won't we?
Aye, and they'll need you too, Maggie, as one of those slinky hostesses in their casino.
I've seen the day when they would. I'll be all right. I've got the bus. I could run excursions and things. But what will the poor folk do who are moved off their farms?
You serious?
Of course I'm serious. Was I ever one to spread idle gossip?
Maggie, who told you all this?
My sources are inviolate.
Dear, Ken, wouldn't it be great if it was true?
Oh, wouldn't it be great about moving all those people out?
No, that wouldn't be great, but wouldn't it be great if all these German millionaires moved in? Think of it, man, you'd have the garage you could go into car hire. I'd have the water sports.
You know, it'd be like having an ice cream barrow in the Sahara.
Well, he says he's told no one, and I believe him.
So we're none the wiser. I still don't believe that reporter was here just to study rural life, though.
Neither do I. He's not the type. He's the sort who worries his way into people's houses after there's been an accident and steals their photographs.
There's been nothing here for the yellow press since the murder years ago.
Oh, it could hardly be that. No, he's interested in Glendarroch House and the estates. Maybe we're underestimating our own people, Alan. They could have put two and two together and made four.
What two and two?
Well, it's common knowledge that a German group has bought Glendarroch and that they are businessmen. It would be reasonable to assume that they bought it as a business proposition.
And the rest follows?
Well, it could. But how people find out doesn't somehow matter quite so much as what they do about it. Do you realize how serious it could be if rumors start going about that sweeping changes are going to be made here?
Oh, I think I do.
They wouldn't wait to be moved out. They'd start looking for places to go now. Especially the young ones. The ones who could get jobs elsewhere. Then what's the point in us trying to preserve a way of life if suddenly it's not going to exist anymore?
Aye.
Do you think I'm making too much of all this?
No. I wish you were.
Max Langerman would probably find it amusing.
That's because he's got bigger fish to fry.
And he shouldn't have bought the fishing rights here. Well, at least he's got the two of us to reckon with. I don't know what I'd have done if you hadn't decided to stay.
Well, I never imagined life would be easy back here. Mind you, I do quite fancy one of his new chalets.
Is that cottage terribly uncomfortable?
No, it's fine.
You don't find it a bit lonely?
I've been alone quite a lot of my life. I like it that way. Hello? Oh, hello, Kay. Dougal. I've no idea where he is. No, I wouldn't call the police just yet. If he's all right and we've no reason to believe that he isn't, he wouldn't take too kindly to that. No, I'll see what I can do. Yes, cheerio. It's Dougal Lachlan. He's gone missing.
Since when?
Last night.
He's been away all night.
Ah, it's not long enough to panic, but it's long enough to worry, especially with Dougal. I mean, he's not the kind of person to stay out all night without telling Grace.
No, he's not.
Since Amy died, he's been like a man with no reason to live.
You don't think he'd do anything foolish?
Oh, I don't think he'd kill himself, if that's what you mean. But he could have broken a leg or something. And that could be serious. There's still a lot of snow up the glen. If he hasn't hurt himself, I think I know where I might find him.
There's a car now. Oh, it's Mr. McIntyre, and he has Dougal with him.
You'll want to talk to Dougal. I don't think he'd want me to be here when you do.
And why not? Your family.
I might be to you, Mrs. Lachlan, but I'm not to Dougal.
You're back. I have the tea on. Would you like a cup, Mr. McIntyre?
Not for me, Mrs. Lachlan. I'll have to get back to work. I'll be seeing you, Dougal.
Well, that was a fine thing to do. We thought something had happened to you.
Something has happened to me. I've lost my wife.
You have your son?
You make it sound like fair exchange.
No, that's not what I meant. I mean, you can't let yourself go to pieces because of Amy's death. You have the boy to think about.
You think about him. I don't want to. And while you're at it, you can think of some way to get Alice out of here.
What have you got against Alice?
I've nothing against her when she's somewhere else. I don't want any women about here just now.
And what do you think I am?
I don't want Alice here.
Dougal, I didn't ask her here for your benefit. I asked her here because I need help. There's all the work to be done here that ever there was, and a baby to be seen to forby. I need somebody to give me a hand.
Right then. If you can't get along without her, I can.
And what does that mean?
One of us will have to go. If it's not her, it'll have to be me, won't it?
I hope what Maggie says is true. Just think, the shop would be a gold mine. You can get someone in to help from the village, and after a while you won't have to work at all.
What would I do then?
You'd find something better than work to pass your time.
Well, I suppose I could take up the water skiing.
Aye, you could. And I'd use my influence to make sure you got a special rate.
Seriously, though, Jimmy, what about the folk?
Oh, they'd all make their fortunes.
Ach, that's not what I mean. The place wouldn't be the same without the folk.
No, it might be an awful lot better. They'd moan and laugh the whole way to the bank.
Well, you know what they say, Jimmy. Old friends are aye the best. I certainly can't see me having much in common with that German millionaire's wife. She'd be telling me how nice it was on the Riviera last summer.
Well, you'll have been to the Riviera yourself by then.
Oh,
hello, Ken.
Give us 20 cigarettes, Jimmy, will you?
Have you seen the man yet?
Yes, he's been. For all that he told me, he might as well not have bothered. I don't think I've answered as many questions since I was up in D&D.
What's D&D?
Drunk and disorderly.
And were you drunk and disorderly?
Well, I think I might have been drunk because I don't remember being disorderly.
So what did the man say to you in the end?
Well, like I said, he never said one thing or the other.
So you've no idea what's going to happen?
Well, no, what's going to happen. He said he'll let me know. It's enough to drive you to drink, so it is.
Listen, I don't suppose that man's in a position to tell you anything, Ken. I mean, he'll have to report to his superiors and let them make the decision.
Well, maybe you're right.
I'm sure you've nothing to worry about. Goodness, you must have made an impression or he wouldn't have said he'd get in touch with you, now would he?
I know I made an impression. I just wonder what sort of impression I made. Can I have those cigarettes?
Oh, sorry.
Now listen, don't you start feeling sorry for yourself, Ken. Goodness, if the worst comes to the worst, and it's not likely to do so, you'll still find plenty to do once you build up your business.
When will that be?
When word gets round that you're good and reliable.
I hope you're right. Thank you. See you.
Cheers. Bye-bye. Cheers, Ken. See you later.
Oh, dear. I hope that works out. A big disappointment could start him drinking again.
There's no need to worry about that. Ken's cured now.
An alcoholic's never cured, Jimmy.
Well, what is he then?
He's an alcoholic who's not drinking.
You're not finished yet. I'm ready for my tea.
Your tea? I'm worked off my feet here and you want your tea.
You're not worked off your feet working for me, that's for sure.
Oh, there's something bothering you, isn't there? You've been acting funny this past day or two. There's something you're not telling me, isn't there?
I just didn't want to worry you.
Oh, you better tell me. It'll worry me till I know what it is. Pass me that waste paper basket.
It's David Blair. He's back. I've seen him myself.
What's he back for?
Well, they say he's doing some work for the government.
Maybe he is.
Aye. And maybe that's not all he's doing. You know, he's never believed that his brother did that murder.
What do you care what he believes? His brother's in jail for it and he'll stay there.
Aye, maybe. But David Blair's a dour man, a determined man. He could cause trouble before he's finished.
What trouble can he cause?
Well, trouble for me, of course.
Only if he finds out. The police never found out, so he's not going to, is he?
I wish I could be as sure of that as you are.
Can be. There's only one person knows you were out that night. I'd like to see David Blair try to get it out of me.
Did you finish in here?
Just this minute.
I were just going to get what.
Hello. Good, you're back. There's a stack of messages.
Oh, not now, Lorna. I've got to see Mrs. Cunningham. Everything else will have to wait.
Oh, some of them shouldn't wait.
Well, just have to.
New trouble?
More like an extension of the old.
Oh, Lorna, I've come down without the mail and it's all signed. Would you mind?
Oh, of course not. I'll see to it now and it'll all go tonight.
Thanks. Well, did you find Dougal?
Yes.
Is he all right?
Well, he's not hurt, if that's what you mean. Apart from that, he's all wrong. And so is everything else. The word about the pleasure complex is all round the place.
And who spread it?
That reporter. He's been up to Dougal's place.
Oh, good grief.
Aye. He's told the Lachlans. God knows how many other people he's told. Dougal's been sitting on his backside ever since his wife died, and we're coming up for our busiest season. So I thought it was time to shake him up a bit. So I told him, if he didn't get a grip of himself and work his farm, then I would get somebody else in who would. And you know what he said? He said it didn't matter whether he worked his farm or not, because they'll all soon be evicted anyway.
What did I tell you?
Do you think if you denied the rumour, it might stop the rot?
How can I deny them when they might be true?
I want to live with the people here, Alan. That's why I came back. It's why I've stayed. I could have sold Glendarroch outright, cleared off and been well out of it, but this estate and the people in it, they're part of me. I could have stayed in Edinburgh, but what I wanted was here. So whatever happens in the future in Glendarroch, I couldn't look the people here in the face again if they thought that I'd lied to them about something that affected their whole lives.
Then what can we do?
I know what we can't do. We can't let this get any bigger. It'll turn into an epidemic.
So?
So? I'll go straight to the root of the problem.
What, the reporter?
Just for once, I wish I could go with a horsewhip.
You might be in a stronger position if he came to you.
Yes, you're right. Would you see to it that he's here tomorrow at 12 noon, punctually?
Come in.
There's something that...
Archie, we're busy.
That reporter, he's out there on the grounds, and he's got a man with him taking photographs.
Do you want me to attend to him?
No, thanks, Alan. I'll take great pleasure in attending to him myself.
Thanks, Archie.
Uh-oh, here comes trouble. Now, just look innocent and go on taking the pictures. I'll handle it. Stormy weather, Mrs. Cunningham.
It could get worse, Mr. Maxwell. What exactly are you doing here?
Our editor is very old-fashioned. He thinks one picture's worth a thousand words, even mine.
But I don't think that you've had the good sense or the good manners to get permission to take these amazingly valuable pictures.
I couldn't see any reason why anybody would object. I mean, you're not developing a death ray behind the peaceful facade of Glendarroch House, are you?
You don't appear to know the difference between secrecy and privacy.
When you invade one, you get shot. When you invade the other, you get reported to the press council. I don't know which is worse.
I wish the choice were mine, Mr. Maxwell.
Look, I can't see why you object to a two-man invasion, when I understand you're expecting a mass invasion quite soon.
I think perhaps we'd better continue this discussion indoors.
Okay. Come on, Parker.
No more pictures, thank you, Mr. Parker.